Hey, I'm Blake Hoffarber, and I'm 6'4 shooting guard from Minnesota, Minnetonka, Minnesota.
Yeah, Nicole, I'm gonna love this, you know. Pool party, if I even the beach, me have to reach a summertime. Hey, every man say, if I come along, go feel your sun tan in the summer sun. If you want to reach, go back home, go feel your umbrella, cause the sun is gone. The young girl, them a bring it on. In a bikini, them in a pretty tongue.
You know, so far in the ballgame, Hoffarber gets inside with a teardrop.
Both more may come from me now. Pretty girl does her phones like dummy now. And the tongues, them a rub them down me now.
Hoffarber cutting through the lane, then Williams.
Uptown full of funny now. ATI, we are going now. Cherry Garden. Dream weekend coming
now. Hoffarber, a quick release, yeah. The three.
I just wanted to, I knew it was going to be a lot different than the States, but I mean, the ball is really competitive out here. Like, basketball-wise, I'm really impressed with the players out here and the type of players. And I didn't know what to expect with, like, living or the city or anything like that. When I first got here, I thought all towns in France were kind of small like this, but then obviously we went to other towns, and like Antibes, and saw a little bigger. I've been to Marseille a little bit, that's pretty cool, so. But yeah, it's going well so far. Players on the team are very accepting of me and good guys, so that helps along with the coach.
I think my role is kind of make the transition as easy as possible, because it's definitely a lot different playing overseas from playing in college. I remember like my first year, the veterans, Americans kind of helped me. We would go out to eat together. We travel around together. Like, I mean, we had days off. We'd go to events together. Kind of just make it seem like, you know, like a family, like we're home, and like a home away from home. So try to make it as comfortable for them. Make them get used to, you know, being in a different country.
I had some offers in some other countries, and kind of throughout the summer we were kind of waiting, and then all of a sudden it got kind of late and turned down a couple late contracts, knowing because I wanted to play in like France or one of the big countries, France, Spain, Italy, but I was just kind of waiting for the right contract, and finally I got a chance to play here and get seen out here, so I came out here for a month, and now things are going really well, so I'm happy with my decision and glad I ended up waiting.
He had messaged me about, I think like 3 or 4 days before he took the contract, and was asking about Pro B, and was asking about Foose, and was asking about what I thought, and should he take the deal, and I was like, buddy, but you should take that, you know. I think Blake is a good player, and he can really play a system. He's got a lot of skills, he can pass, I think he's unselfish. I think a lot of clubs will be, you know, impressed with when they see him in person, and they'll be impressed with him.
Non, je connaissais pas parce que je suis pas trop la NCAA, mais bon, j'ai pu voir assez vite les petites vidéos postées et me rendre compte qu'effectivement c'était quand même un joueur assez reconnu en NCAA.
Back in the day, my freshman year in college at the University of Minnesota, we played Indiana, who was ranked at the time, and was in the Big Ten tournament. So we're up by 2 right now, and they missed the free throw. And got a put back on the free throw. Then they missed it again when it's tied. It's just kind of game of emotions, just up, down, up, down. Now it's tied. Now they finally made it with 1.5 seconds left. So I still felt like we had a chance to win the game. A lot of people probably didn't, but Travis Bush was taking it out of bounds, passed at the full length of the court. I saw it coming, just shot it up quick, and it ended up going in. So people actually went crazy. My team, I was running to the corner, and one of my teammates actually tackled me, and then there was a hog pile on me, so it kind of got hurt at that time, but it was definitely a fun experience for me in front of that whole crowd. Most of those people were, it was in Indiana, and we were playing in Indiana, so most of those people were rooting against us, and when we finally won that game, it was just, it was crazy. So then people started obviously talking about my high school shot and how crazy that was. This one was actually more crazy than the one in college to me. I was just sitting on the floor by the three-point line, and the ball just happened to get in my hands, and I shot it when I was on the ground, and it went in. But to have it happen twice in my life, and I got to go to the ESPYs twice, it was definitely a dream come true and just kind of a weird moment in my life.
Blake is a very good shooter. He's a smart player. Plays hard. Plays D. The sky's the limit. He can, you know, go as far as he wants to go. He's young, so he can just improve and get better.
It's a lot better than I thought. The players and the teams and stuff like that. But it's more different, and there's more like set plays. There's more like defensive tactics, like more stuff like that, but I guess that's professional basketball compared to college basketball. But I'd say I'm getting used to it, but it's there's minor kind of things that are different, but mostly it's just basketball.
On ESPN3.com, there's kind of, you can see some top level European games, like Spain games and stuff like that, and I kind of always watch that because my uncle, my high school coach, actually always watches it because there's more kind of plays over here, so he always studies the game and tries to get different plays, so I always watched it with him. But I never kind of, when I first heard about playing in France, I actually YouTubed it and looked up some of like the highlights and stuff from Pro B and stuff like that, but I never watched the full game of French game actually.
Pur shooter, arrière shooter, très impressionnant d'ailleurs. J'ai rarement vu des joueurs aussi adroits, un peu dans le style de Sean Fain. Après quelqu'un en dehors du basket, de très très intéressé par la culture, par très très curieux, très très ouvert, qui discute facilement, qui pose beaucoup de questions. Vraiment une intégration très facile dans l'équipe. Déjà, les joueurs de cette équipe sont assez cool en général. C'est très bien intégré et c'est ce qui permet aussi pour lui, je pense, de pouvoir individuellement s'en sortir comme ça.
Ça va, salut, bonjour, j'ai faim. What else do I know? Merci.
Okay.
So just kind of the main basics right now.
Yeah,
it's a tough language, everyone says. I try to ask people, you know, how do you say you, and they give me different ways of how to say it, and I'm like, you know, there's not just one way, and they're like, no, there's different grammatical stuff. The one thing I was surprised coming out here, I thought nobody was going to be able to speak English, and I thought I was just going to be just talking to some of the Americans, but I'm amazed on how many people know English, especially on the team. All but one kid knows English, so pretty good, pretty easy.
It was a little difficult to get here, but we wanted to make a point to come to France and see him play in the French league. And they play a very good quality of basketball, and we're very happy to have seen two games last week on Friday and this Friday, and they won both games, so we're happy.
The first couple weeks, the internet here was a little bad, so it was kind of tough. But ever since then I've been using kind of Skype, Facebook, iChat, just kind of video chat. I try to talk to him every day, and it kind of keeps, because sometimes in between practices you're kind of bored here. TV's in French, so I really don't know how to watch that. So I try to talk to him as much as possible, which helps. I always imagine, what if there was no internet? I don't know what I'd do. I don't feel too alone. I mean, I always kind of grew up in Minnesota, then I went to college in Minnesota, so it's kind of a big difference to go somewhere else, especially across the world. I I go out with Bill Clark a lot. We go around, kind of go to the grocery store and walk around a little bit. So it kind of, I still want to just experience more and get to know this lifestyle a little more. I'd love to stay in France. Yeah, I like it so far. I'd love to see more of France, if not more of Europe. But so far, so good. I'm enjoying my experience, and hopefully I can keep playing professional basketball, and whether it's here, hopefully, or somewhere else.